Welkom, dear brothers and sisters in our Lord Jesus Christ and all who are assisting this sermon. I would like to speak about the law and the Christian. The law for the Christian. Yes, the law for the Christian. The law is for everybody. For unbelievers, believers, Christians, everybody, every person on earth. You can't say the law is not valid for me. There are various ways you can interpret the law and how it is applicable to your life. The law started in Genesis and was given, if I may say so, to Adam and Eve. The law was, you may eat of all the fruit trees in the garden except for one, that tree has forbidden fruits which you are not allowed to eat from. Well, first Eve was seduced and she brought the forbidden fruit to her husband Adam. And he had the free choice consciously to eat against the law, against what God had forbidden, and to choose for his wife and get the punishment, death. Consciously, he chose to eat from the forbidden fruit. And in the evening, God came, and Adam and Eve, they hide themselves. They knew very well that they went wrong. God asked responsibility of Adam and Eve. They blamed each other. And God pointed that they went wrong. God took one or two animals because without blood shedding, Hebrew 9, verse 22, there is no forgiveness of sin. They were thrown out of paradise, and that was the first law. God took their spirit and Adam and Eve, they went living on, told to the descendants what had happened, the sin, the disobedience to the law, the sacrifice of the innocent blood of an animal. That continued for about 2,400, 2,500 years until the law was given on the Mount of Sinai. The law was written in the hearts of the people, and people like today, they throw away, they don't wish to know anything. They throw out God. There was the flood, the construction of the Tower of Babel. God punish them by giving various languages and there was Noah who was saved through the water with his family because he was the only one who believed in God. But after the flood, Noah, he got drunk, laid down naked, and there started a terrible sin that one of his sons threw his father naked. Again and again, people rejected God until there was Abraham. He was called from his country and guided by God to the promised land, Israel. He brought sacrifices and he believed God. And God made a covenant with him. There was a great hunger in the land, in the promised land. And he and his descendants went to Egypt. And there, the Pharaoh, after about 400 years, they make slaves of the Israelites, but there was a faithful man called Moses, and God called Moses to save the Israelites and guide them out of Egypt. When they were guided out of Egypt, 3 months later, they arrived at the Mount Sinai. And there God wrote with his finger on stones the law, the Ten Commandments. The law are the 5 first Bible books called the Pentateuch or Torah, the books of Moses, which contains the complete law of God in writing, and that is written for about and valid for about 1,700 years when the law was given to Moses until the teachings of Jesus. You can say it is Adam's guilt, he went wrong, so what can I help? I'm a sinner, but we have the law. Individual mensje, everyone has his conscience, he knows what is good and wrong. If you go back to that time from creation to the law, the conscience of men to adore and obey God the Creator. God is the creator of the universe, heaven and earth. No Big Bang, and all the other religions, Hinduism, Buddhism, Islam. So 600 years after the birth of Jesus, in the 17th century, the creation of the Mormons. That's why Judaism and Christianism is the only true belief because it exists. And all the others came after the Bible. And besides that, it is the only religion in which the Son of God died for the sin of men. You can try to keep the law, but you will fall. The first five commandments is to honor your Creator, to honor God, not to adore and bow down for man-made images. All five first commandments is to worship only God, your Creator. God created the universe, the earth, the trees, the birds, the fishes, the grain. God gave rain so that the fruit trees will give fruit. You have food meals with grains that are called the laws of nature. The laws of nature, if you don't sleep, you continue working hard, in the end you will die. If you eat not healthy or drink not healthy, like Noah, getting drunk, using drugs. I love to eat, get fat, eat not healthy, frightened food. You are living unhealthy, you will get health problems. And we have also the laws of the sacrifices given on the Mount of Sinai, the tabernacle, with all the sacrifices. The Israelites, when they commit a sin, they had to bring a sacrifice. All in those five books and their ceremonies. Because without blood shedding, there is no forgiveness of sin. Like a plant, a seed falls in the ground, it flourishes, bears fruit, and it withers and dies and returns to seed. That are the laws of nature. The laws of nature is when a semen fertilizes an egg cell. And there starts the division, the eyes are formed, the ears, the mouth, the organs, the body, the brain. That are the laws of nature. You can't interfere with them. But you need to obey the commandments of God. They are for your best. And the five last commandments is the relation, the interrelation with men. How you go on and treat your neighbor. You shall not steal, you shall not covet, you shall not murder. That's for the best. The laws of the government, the traffic rules, they are for the best, for the interrelation, that everything will go for the best. Unfortunately, nowadays, they kill for a cellular. They steal because they are using drugs. They are not caring about themselves. They are maltreating the neighbor. A lot of adultery, pornographia, easy access on the internet. There is no faithfulness anymore. The law. May I say those 10 commandments for the Israelites? They were easy. They were failed and are failed for those 1500 years from when the 10 commandments were given until the teachings of Jesus. And Jesus, he said in Matthew 22, the verses 37 to 39, when the Pharisee asked, "Teacher, which is the great commandment in the law?" And Jesus said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind." Meaning, putting God in the first place. This is the great and first commandment. And the second commandment is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets. And Jesus explained further in the Sermons of the Mountain, Matthew 5, 6 and 7. They are much harder than those 10 commandments. Those sermons and those laws are failed for every Christian and for every man on earth. A few examples. In those sermons on the mountains, Jesus says, "Give food and drink to your enemies. If you see a woman, confront her, you already have committed adultery." The whole New Testament is full of guidance for Christians how to live. That is the law since the teaching of Jesus Christ when he was on earth. They continue to be valid until today and continued in the Great Tribulation, the 1000 years of kingdom of Jesus Christ, the millennium, until the new earth and the new heaven, when the laws will be written in our hearts. The law convinces of sin. That's the purpose of the law. Jesus himself said, "I have come to fulfill the law." That is our way. In our own strength, we are incapable. And for that, the Holy Spirit is giving us to convince us of sin, to give us the power to live blameless. Confessing our sins, saying no to sin. Because Abraham had it easy. He had only one law. Do not eat of the forbidden fruit. And we have many commandments, the 5 Bible books of Moses, the New Testament. You can't blame Adam. You can choose. You can say no. If we know that we are incapable, and we need Jesus Christ as our Savior and Lord, with the strength of the Holy Spirit, we can keep the law. The law doesn't bring righteousness, doesn't bring forgiveness. The sacrifices of the animals doesn't and didn't bring salvation, eternal life. It was only covering. Until the perfect sacrifice on the cross was made by Jesus Christ. The cross brings salvation, brings the Holy Spirit to live in you after you are reborn. The cross is your way for eternal life, to heaven. Dear brothers and sisters, and all those who are yet unbelievers, recognize your sin. Recognize that you need Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. May the Holy Spirit open your eyes, give you from minute to minute peace and strength until the eternal glory with God the Father and Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bless you. Amen.